name, it's Inge Gajcik. I came to Australia 25 years ago to share life with my Australian partner. After living in central western Queensland, we now live in Pittsworth. I'm a photographer, and today I'm going to take you on a photo walk through the main street of Pittsworth, and along the way, give you some tips to improve your photography. This workshop is brought to you by Youth Connect and Toowoomba Regional Council. You can take a photo walk in your local park or neighborhood, or even in your own backyard or around the house. You will need a camera. You can use the one in your smartphone, tablet, or compact camera. I use a DSLR camera, but keep in mind the following tips I will share apply to all cameras. At the start of my photo walk, I went in search of an object and strolled along Pittsworth Main Street, where I discovered this wonderful hibiscus plant. I went closer and walked around the plant for a close-up with the sun behind my back. If you shoot with the sun behind the object, it will be a silhouette or too dark to see. So, take a few seconds to position yourself in relation to the sun. I kept walking towards this fantastic old building and looked for the best angle for my image. Shooting from different angles can make your photos say different things. Shooting from a low angle with the camera pointing up can make the building look tall and powerful. Shooting from a high angle with the camera pointing down can allow the viewer to have a bird's eye view or make anything at the ground level look small and powerless. However, before you press a shutter, think about what goes where in your image. Most people tend to position their subject in the dead center of the frame. Better use the rule of thirds, which has been used by great artists and painters for centuries. Imagine your camera's viewfinder dissected into thirds by four lines. Place your subject matter or the horizon on one of these lines and you will get a more dynamic perspective. Of course, all creative rules are suggestions and are meant to be broken. I think it is important to have a clutter-free image and focus on the subject only. So, before shooting, I made sure that there was no rubbish floating around, disturbing my shot. I ended up in one of the local parks and found some roses. Now I walked around my object to find a natural arch or some tree branches to frame this image. Again, I looked out for distracting subjects like water hose or rubbish bins. Other frames that you might find on your photo walk includes windows, door frames, or the small gaps in a fence. Every time when taking photographs, it is important to get the horizon straight. To get those fantastic images you often see in magazines, don't position your subject in the dead center of the picture. It is very important, if you photograph a person, to ask for permission before you take the shot. If photographing children, ask the parents or adults escorting the child. Most important, accept a no and still be friendly and polite. But now let's put all together. Before you take a photograph, walk around your subject and keep your eyes open. Secondly, explore different ways of photographing the same thing. Thirdly, try to get your subject in a frame. Think about the rule of thirds and that the main subject not in the middle and get your horizon straight. Don't forget to get rid of distracting subjects like water hose and rubbish bins. Most importantly, ask for permission if you take pictures of people. But now go out and practice and have fun. We love to see the photos you take. You can share them using the hashtag HomeProjectTR.